Hey, buddy, it's Invicta. It's time to begin a brand new week here in the Mosh Pit after yesterday's interesting run. If you didn't see yesterday's random run day, you are missing out on what was called one of the most exciting runs that we've ever had for probably not the right reasons, although some people would probably beg to differ with that. But either way, thank you all very much for liking that video and also liking this video and all the other ones. I appreciate it. We're still waiting for the next video to cross 5,000 likes to get us back on track for Fiendish Fridays. I almost said Fiendfolio Fridays. I guess it technically is Fiendfolio Fridays. But yeah, thank you all very much. Hope your weeks have gone off to a great start. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you here by, I'm going to say, Zozigal. Title of the thread was, Fingies Cross, no one made this yet. More! yeah. You know, I gotta say, I was really impressed with Sumptorium. That was an interesting application, which of course got overshadowed by the damage bug that we saw with Tech Zero. But I digress. Still a very fun episode nonetheless. 37XZWFX. My favorite radio station in Seattle. I don't know why I said Seattle. I'm not a big fan of Seattle. Not the football team. I'm sure that the actual city is great and beautiful and has great weather, except for the rain all the time, which is fine with me because I actually do enjoy rain. Never actually been up there. I've been the furthest north I've ever gone is Alaska. That's about it. And we drove there and it was a long drive, man. Alaska is one of my favorite states to have ever visited, though. Definitely would love to go back there. It's definitely got my weather, that's for sure. I'm ready for this cool weather to finally hit us here. This summer has been way too hot. I mean, way too hot. Like, when you know it's hot outside whenever you, like, try to do anything and you are just soaked. Like, I was outside, I had to adjust the sprinkler system in my backyard because obviously, like, you know, water ordinances and all that kind of good stuff. And I was out there for, like, maybe 5 minutes, and, like, I was just sweating. It was... this is interesting. Wait on that. We could use the Yara Rune for the Soul Heart and the Mini Charge, which would give us another free bomb on my best friend. Maybe we'll find something else extra here for Yara. We're starting out here with decent tears rate, decent damage after getting Bozo. Nothing to really write home about. Good movement speed. Okay shot speed. Really bad range, though. Also have... we've got less than three, and then my best friend, of course. My best friend is a bomb that's essentially going to attract and taunt all of the enemies in the room. It was very, very useful for basically drawing aggro. Probably could have used... I thought about for half a second to use Yara there, but I think that we can probably still get a better use out of it. If we end up getting something like a... if we end up getting something like a bunch of bombs or keys, because obviously, like, we have absolutely zero bombs or cash right now. See if we can coax Limehorn here into going after my best friend. Nope. Gonna harmlessly blow up on the side of the room over there. So we do get the fear effect here from Bozo. Then that basically just comes from us just facing the enemy. It's a little bit of a wonky tier effect. Wonkier than most, I would say. Also, of course, we are starting with a Curse of the XL, which means that we are going to have a double deal on this floor. And this is the only times that you really won't hear me complain too much about having a Curse of the XL on floor one. It gets the first two floors out of the way pretty easily. The only downside is that you do lose one shop and one curse room and one secret room and one super secret room. But it's not that detrimental because it doesn't really affect the devil deal. Where it does start getting bad is if it's on floor three and four. That's when you have a legit complaint, in my opinion, about Curse of the Labyrinth. That goes Limehorn. We do get another HP upgrade here and an Eternal Heart. Yeah. I don't ever do that again. I saw that. I'm going to pass on these, honestly. Like... it feels a little bit strange to pass on two books there, but again, talking about the risk-reward management of... the risk-reward management of the Satanic Bible, and, you know, it's not worth... Yeah, I mean, yes, it is worth having a Soul Heart generator. We saw that on the Tainted Random Run Day run yesterday, obviously. That was pretty much one of the few things that... that saved our lunch. We have to go in the big room, aren't we? Yep. One of the few things that really did kind of save us was the fact that we did have the Satanic Bible, but that's kind of a special circumstance because obviously it's tainted cane, so you know there's a little bit of a different situation there because we're not really penalized for using the Satanic Bible and not getting boss items as opposed to like you know a run where we're sitting here in Eden. And if we had the Satanic Bible, we wouldn't be getting those boss item drops. So that is the primary source of all of your big like damage upgrades and big tiers upgrades, that sort of thing. So it's something to really take pause about. And I'm not really willing to give up. We do have a lot of HP here, but I'm going to end up using this HP probably for the sack room, which means that we are going to lose this eternal heart. Okay, and actually that was actually a mistake. I should have taken Magic Mush after hitting the sack room because that would have actually healed us for full. So that's me just being too excited. But we are going to get Magic Mush here, which is a big time get for us. Now, of course, with this Yara room, we can also Yara all the money that we have on the ground. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to wait to pick up stuff until after. Oh my goodness, we got Miter. I'm going to wait on using the Yara rune until we get to the payout for the soul hearts or for the money. I'm gonna back out here. Then this is the moment of truth here. The reason why I'm leaving the money as well is just if we are going to dedicate ourselves into burying this, I want to get as much money as possible. I actually wouldn't mind money here. Soul hearts is fine. One, two, three. I mean, we only get 7 soul hearts. I'm actually going to wait. I'm not going to error this. I would have been more convinced had we gotten a bunch of money, but this gives us more. If we would have errored that, we really would not have gained. We would have gained an extra 3 cents, and that's it. I think waiting on Yara there is the smart play, is the smart thing to do. So we're not going to end up erroring this. These are free bomb up here. We'll head on Dizown. So very, very strong start here thanks to Magic Mush. Yeah, let's go alt path. We got a good start here. This can't possibly go wrong, right? People have been wanting to see alt path, so let's give you a little bit of alt path. A little bit of alt path. An extra couple of likes for alt path here. One key gets us 2 bombs. I think that's a really good deal here. Obviously, Magic Mush is going to give us the all stats up, everything but tiers, and also an HP upgrade. But more importantly, we get the damage upgrade and the damage multiplier, which is muy bueno, as the Spanish mosh pit would say, except that they'd say it in a much cooler way than I would, because I've absolutely no accent flair to put on anything. Ozo does produce us a rainbow poop, which is going to give us a full heal. We get a judgment card as well. We're just going to laugh and leave behind. I am going to take the cancer. Did they put an invisible button there? Get the cancer trinket, which is, or the cancer item, which is going to give us that wafer effect every time we take damage. After the first instance of damage, all other damage is going to be rounded down to a half heart, essentially, unless we get hit by a super champion. And Miter is going to help us out with the soul heart generation as well. What? You can handle that. Have fun. Here's our white fires. We could go get the key piece now. I'd rather see who we've got for the boss first. Now remember, this is great because we had an XL floor on the first and second floor, meaning that we get the boosted Devil Deal or Angel Deal chance here on floor 3 much higher than it normally would be. Had we not had an XL floor. So this is one of the few times where again, having an XO floor on the first floor actually does pay out. Unless, of course, we get skunked on the devil deal, which is definitely a possibility, and I'm going to try to avoid that by blowing up the Rotten Beggar, which does count as a special judgment, so we get a little bit of extra boost here from that. So now we have a what is essentially going to be an 85% chance for a deal with the devil or deal with the angel. Either one is going to be fine with me as long as we get it, which means that we most likely probably won't get it. Enjoy, Turdlet. You get another devil deal, and we get a tier and range up, or tier size and range up. I am going to take Bloody Gust, as it does give us a movement speed upgrade, but also gives us a tiers upgrade. And we do have enough to really make the shop worthwhile here. We also found the secret room thanks to this. What is that? What is that pathing? There's another bomb here, and I will take the treasure map. Or the blue map, I should say. At least this helps us get a little bit of a better idea of where to go for our secret room and super secret room. Now, I'm not going to lie. I don't really trust Turdlet a whole lot. And we really, really could use an extra damage upgrade, though. So let's try to push hard for this. I mean, Turdlet at least is pretty hard countered by my best friend, so we just got to be ultra careful because obviously we only have the Holy Mantle and that's it for defense. We do have to fight a long way to the boss, but I think it is going to be worth it here. Gotta just sneak our way to one of the death buttons. Got a couple extra bombs here as well. Again, Turdlet, we already know what's going to happen here. Tee off on him. There we go. There we go. And look at that. We get ourselves a movement speed and shot speed up. Hey, you know what? It's definitely worth it. The only bosses I really shy away from the second go around on the boss items for alt path really comes down to Wormwood, and I really don't like fighting Min Min as well. Also, Colostomy is also pretty bad. And Curse of the Blind. Womp, 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 womp. Well, there's two ways you can look at Curse of the Blind. And as we saw from Blind Items Week, which feels like a million years ago at this point, where blind items don't really seem to have all that big of an impact in terms of regular item rooms. However, secret rooms and super secret rooms are where we take a little bit of a pause. Remember, we still have this Yara rune too, so if we do get in trouble HP-wise, we can use the Yara rune or... we could try to save it for a bunch of a golden treasure chests when we have a key or something like that. This is one of those times where the super secret room does not betray the location of the boss room. And honestly, since we're alt path, like we could just go straight up for the blind item on the right side of the item room if we wanted to. These shots are quite something. Use another bomb here just to give us a boosted shot at a devil deal. We do have we've got plenty of HP to make the devil deal at least somewhat tempting. Hey. We're going to take Nod Leaf. No idea what the other one was. Anyone playing the seed, let me know in the comments down below, of course. You need to die. Thank you. Honestly, was expecting a greed fight in here. The shops really are now starting to migrate in the meta towards, I don't want to take these if they're blind just because it's a waste of money. I want to buy something blind. By the way, somebody asked why do I wiggle like that sometimes whenever I'm going up against host. Thank God we got past this room. There's no reason for it. It's just to kind of taunt the host. It doesn't do anything in the game. Got to go up against the core hounds here. I don't remember if I can actually hit their bones or not. Like if I can walk over them. Bit of a quick shot there. Let me pile. Interesting. Did get the damage on pile, which is honestly surprising considering how far away it was from us, from our best friend. Seeing the nice little tears upgrade we got here from Bloody Gust. Bro. Get meat, which is going to give us a damage upgrade and an HP upgrade. I will go for the 2 Heart Devil deal item. Maul the Void, okay. And Heartbreak. well, I mean, hey, it's damage. Is indeed damage so far. A little bit of a greed play there. The Maw of the Void is definitely going to help us out here. And, you know, I got to say that we've been talking about the last time that we saw Maw of the Void, which was not that long ago, sometime last week. And Maw of the Void's quickly been climbing back up the charts in terms of power curve and the meta and everything. I mean, like, it's pretty impressive just how important Maw of the Void can be to a run. There's no reason to take these yet. Now, if you're wondering where we got the Broken Hearts from, they came from Heartbreak. Heartbreak's just going to give us 3 broken hearts, and it gives us damage every time we get a broken heart. Cursed Eye is precisely why we do not want to take blind items inside of a curse room. 2 rotten hearts, so we got to be a little bit careful, but we are going to be generating those flies that are very useful for damage as well. But going back to Maw of the Void, you know, Maw of the Void's really been making a little bit of a comeback here. It's certainly not up to its former glory, because it used to just be an automatic win, but I gotta say, it's getting a little bit automatic winny. It's getting kind of automatic-y winny. There's no way to articulate that any better, I don't think. I mean, I guess there could be, but I'm not smart enough to do it. Drop a bomb here. I know it's not going to go anywhere. I'm just simply boosting our Devil Deal chance. Yeah, we'll take that. That's our second yellow button. The third one's going to be in that long room, because it always is. Go do the Indiana Jones run. Did spawn a... that was a reverse judgment card. So that could also be interesting. I mean, we could throw that in the curse room. We do have enough money to kind of make it worthwhile, but there's also birthright inside of the... there's also birthright inside of the shop, which we could also use to reroll. So, but before we get ahead of ourselves, let's go ahead and go do the mother run real quick. Let's get this done underway. All right, the alt tabs that you see there are me moving in World of Warcraft. I'm trying to time them to where I don't have to do it like while we're in the run, but at the same time, it's like, well, it's either I either move and avoid the AFK timer, or I wait in queue for 4 hours. 2022, we're still waiting in World of Warcraft queues. Who would have thought? Sometimes I feel like they do queues deliberately. That's funny, game. Unfortunately for you, we don't need any HP yet. Of all the companies out there that you would think that have figured out server queues, it would have been Blizzard by now. I mean, they started the trend of server queues in WoW. And here we are. Gonna yeet mom up to the north here, and we're gonna keep moving. Now, I will admit that at the time of this recording, I do not know the score of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers versus the Dallas Cowboys game. Actually recording this before that game started. The reason why I'm doing that is because I want to watch the game. I want to watch the game without being stressed out about anything else other than, you know, are the Bucs winning? Did the Bucs win? Is Tom okay? Those are the three main motivating factors in my day. Furic Acid is going to give us another much needed damage upgrade, although it does trigger one of the bad gas effects. Okay, so here's what we do for this. I think what we do is we go get Blood Rites. We should get Blood Rites and, or Birthright, not Blood Rites, and see what we can come up with out of the rerolls. Because Birthright is going to give us three random items for Eden. Contagion's pretty good, but we've got Maw of the Void. We can do a little bit better. Oh, never mind. Okay, it just apparently doesn't roll it. All right. Oh. Okay. I mean, you would think that it would roll the... you know, all item pedestals, but apparently it only rerolls what's on the floor in the store, so... Well, hey, now we know. Did that on purpose. I knew there was a soul heart in here anyway. I gotta go all the way back and get the other soul heart. I think we still could make boss rush if we hurry. Actually, no, that's... ambitious, unless if we get our fool card and we also get choose the right way to go for the mom fight, we might get boss rush with Maw of the Void. You can never really count it out, especially with us having sulfuric acid, but with only 20 seconds or so by the time we get there, it's gonna be okay. Let's just be stupid, I guess. Good job, brain. Oh, never mind. We're on Gehenna 1. Never mind. Boss rush ain't happening. So we're rushing that entire time and run over the same spikes twice for literally no gain. Well done. The secrets. I'll take over the my best friend. We're not really using it anymore. We've got bombs now. My best friend is still good. It's just that we got really no need for him anymore. Think about that, game. I think I'm gonna wait for that red poop to respawn just so you can use your fancy schmancy mega spikes. Can I move? And a rock over there. Now, if you're wondering why these rocks are breaking, it's because of the sulfuric acid effect. We actually do get a destruction effect out of them. Out of the props. We can also use that in case of bombs as well, which is another reason why I don't really need the my best friend. See right here. Have a chance to get rid of the broken hearts here. Yeah, we got rid of one of them. Gonna be Visage. And we get an HP upgrade. No deal with the devil. So let's go see what this dice room is. If it's a five room, that'd be okay with me. It's so hard. Yeah. I was kind of hoping for some red hearts here. I want to get rid of our broken hearts. Yes, getting rid of the broken hearts does actually reduce your damage, I believe, because you get rid of the present broken hearts. But I'm okay with that. Because we have Maw of the Void, we have a little bit more damage forgiveness than we normally would at this time. Bro, just die. Thank you. Loving our tears upgrade, by the way. It's a full reroll. No, thank you. I think I will disincline the acquiescence of proposition. Also not the proper way to say that. Ooh, we get a unicorn poop, which is going to give us a full heal. So thank you, Bozo. Yeah, so if you look at that, it's actually removing damage from us right now. Which again, I think is fine in this spot, just because I didn't really want Broken Heart anyway. And I also have the damage to make up for, and the utility with Maw of the Void. We get Redemption! Whoa! That's quite interesting now. Okay. Book of Secrets gives us the treasure map effect, or the compass effect, or the blue map effect. There's a sack room here. Interesting room. I will take Roid Rage just because it's our second syringe item, and we're only one away from Spun now. Gotta be careful when this blows up because the spikes are gonna move. Okay. Moved a lot faster than I was expecting. Thank you, that was very convenient. Lots of money. We are going to get one more store out of Gahanna here, but I'm not willing to use the Yara rune for it. I think the Yara rune kind of turns into a... It goes into a utility slash, like, oh poop moment. Because, like, we need to... If we need the HP, we can get it. We can double it. We find a soul heart. Are we probably going to need it? No, probably not. But it's nice to know that we have it just in case. What do I have to say about this room? EH Dizzle. Range up. Range up's pretty good for Maw of the Void. Haven't really been seeing too many pills lately, anyway, on this run. We saw a couple of triple pills early on, but obviously we didn't have PhD, so we're not going to be taking those. The range up is very nice for a multitude of reasons. I get Tajin going ham and cheese on a taco biscuit ham bone right now. But remember, this is Alt Path Mom, which she does a little bit different attacks. She'll also stomp sometimes differently as well. We go on that. We're going to take the negative for the damage bonus. And, Redemption's going to get kind of mad at us, but at the same time, we get a nice damage upgrade from these Invicta robes. And sure, we'll take Missing Page. Let's take our Money Equals Power first. Our Redemption. Not sorry. Missing Page number 2 doesn't matter anyway. Very good. Very good. It's muy bueno. I gotta say, man, like, Bloody Gus has really helped us out a whole lot. It's been a while since I've seen that pattern. You get our soul heart back anyway. Let's head on down to Corpse. Almost got logged out of WoW. That would have been bad. You be careful of the poison gas here. If you stand in the fumes for too long, you will take damage. C-section babies. There you go. And hey, look at that. We got the compass effect. So money equals power, of course, is going to give us more damage based on the amount of money that we are currently have, or that we are currently holding on to. So again, another very nice damage upgrade to go along with Maw of the Void and Magic Mush, of course. We get health up. Yeah, I mean, we can take it. Don't need to really double it, I don't think. We've already established that our health is going to be pretty okay here. Now, this is actually a really odd place for the super secret room. You would think that it would be closer to the boss. Oh, we don't want an internal heart. There's a little bit of an odd placement there. I've been trying to use sulfuric acid to skip rooms. Not that we need to, of course, but it is nice to, like, you know, just be like, yeah, I don't feel like doing this room. Heard the regen there from Placenta as well. This will be our last chance for a double deal here against Chimera. We get another HP upgrade. Sure, why not? I mean, we've got the cancer item, so it's fine. Just moving right along here. I was kind of hoping that we were going to get a chance to use Lost Soul Buddy, or your Soul Buddy, I guess. Didn't happen. Section Baby's trying to pull some schmooves on us here. See if we can get another nickel here for damage. I don't know if Mom is this side or not. You want some good dodge training rooms there. There you go. But we're gonna go down here and destroy Mother, hopefully pretty easily. And hey, give it up for Alt Path. People have been wanting to see an Alt Path run lately, so it was a good run to get here with Maw of the Void, Magic Mush, of course, helping us out big time, along with us getting the cancer item. Didn't actually mean to hit that unicorn poop, but that's all right. Also, shout out to our Yara rune, which actually didn't matter at all. So We're gonna take damage deliberately here because we want to have a tears upgrade, right? Right? Yeah, that's the reason why that's happening. And when you've got the advantage here, take it. Maxing out our tears rate from Bloody Gust. I think this is probably the most annoying pattern that she has, other than wow, we're getting double tapped like crazy there. Other than I don't mind the grid one. This one's pretty easy to avoid. The volleyball section. This one's probably my most hated Mother pattern here. Hey, she finally did it. There we go. Got her with the bomb dunk. See you later, mother. Down she goes. Alt path done. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. And again, hope you have a great start to your week here. If you did, make sure you click that like button down below. Leave a comment. Let me know what your favorite synergy is with Maw of the Void, since we had ourselves a nice Maw run today. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Relat01, Troy Mason, Julian LaFond, Thomas Fisher, Tyrone Rangers, and KOU Indon. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find at patreon.com/Sinvicta.